Hi, today we are going to learn about dateline. Whenever we study history, we frequently see the letters BC, AD, BCE and CE written next to a year. What do these letters mean? This video gives us the answer to this and few other questions. So let's get started. Hello and welcome to another video in social science. Today we are looking at what the terms AD, BC, CE and BCE mean. So first let's understand why these labels exist. Every year in history has been given a number. For example, an XYZ school was established in the year 1998. So where did this number come from? In Europe, during the Middle Ages, it was decided that in order to assign numbers to each of the years, they had to start from somewhere, counting from a single point in time. By taking a single point in time, you can number every event in history based on how many events were there between the two events. Now, since this decision to number the years was made in Europe during the Middle Ages, they decided to use as the starting point the date they considered the most important in history, the birth of Jesus Christ. So suppose we take an example of an event that took place, say a war. It took place 10 years before the birth of Christ. They labeled it as 10 BC, that is 10 years before the birth of Christ. As a result, the years in BC accounted backwards, just like negative numbers in maths. So, when you talk of larger numbers before BC, those events happened before smaller years BC. Confused? Let's understand this with an example. and BC is used in place of BC. But both are placed after the years. In this case, both CE and BCE are placed after the years. However, they still measured time based on the same date that was believed to be the birth of Jesus Christ. This timeline should make it clear to you about the terms BC and AD and BCE and CE. Take a look. But remember one thing, although these terms refer to the same years on a timeline, they cannot be intermixed. That is, BC and AD can only be used together and BCE and CE can only be used together. So I hope now you are clear as to how to use these terms with dates in history. Keeping this in mind, here's a small activity you can try out at home for practice. Try and make your life's timeline like the pic shown. Use your own creativity and ideas and try to make one. So that's all for today. Until next time, goodbye.